So the new Godot 4 alpha version just dropped, and with it we can play with the new tile map we all awaited. And you guys wanted a tutorial on how to use that thing. So here it is. Let's make a little scene using this tileset you can get for free on itch.io. We add a tilemap to the scene and add a tileset to the tilemap. Here we can set the size of the individual tiles, 16x16 in our case. We get greeted with the message, this tilemap's tileset has no source configured. Added the tileset resource to add one. And I will not lie, I searched up here first, because I think this is the tileset resource. But what this message means is this tab all the way down here. It also says tileset, and only is visible when we select the tilemap on the top left. So we click that. We can drag our image in and it will automatically be split into tiles. It's so smart, it even leaves empty tiles out. The image is now called a tile atlas. We can delete it with this trash can. Pressing delete will ask to delete the whole tilemap currently. To delete tiles, use the eraser. Now we can make a single large tile for the tree by deactivating the eraser and holding shift while dragging over the tree's tiles. We can also change tiles manually by clicking the cursor icon and then on the tile. Notice these little circles? You can use them to expand the tile. Now let's map a little. Go to the tilemap tab. We can select a bunch of tiles down here and just start mapping. We can paint tile by tile, hold shift to draw lines, and even hold shift and control to draw a rectangle. We can also switch between these tools with these buttons or the keys D, L and R. There's also a fill tool and a picker in the bar, or we press control to pick the tile. When we select multiple tiles, by drawing a rect down in the lower window or by pressing shift, we can place many of these tile arrangements at once. We can also enable place random tile, so we get a random tile from our selection. If we enable scatter, sometimes no tile is placed. This is great to quickly decorate larger areas. To move tiles, draw a rect with the selection tool and then just drag the selected tiles. We now got the option to define patterns for tile combinations we frequently use. Just map it out, select it with the selection tool and copy paste it into the patterns tab. We can now select them from there and place many of that kind. Another awesome new feature are the tilemap layers. You define them in the property editor on the right. This allows you to draw multiple layers of tiles onto each other. For example, a ground layer, a layer for ground level objects, and one for air level objects that characters can walk behind. Each layer can have its own z-index, and you can hide them individually. Now let's take a look at terrains. Terrains are the new auto tiles, but they are more flexible and intuitive. You add terrains in the editor on the right under Tileset Terrains. First, you add a terrain set and configure the auto tile mode. Match sides is 2x2, match corners is minimal 3x3, and match corners and sides is full 3x3. We have minimal 3x3 here. Then add the terrains. We can name them and give them a color. I want grass and water. To define them, go to the Tileset tab, click on the Paint tool, choose terrains, and then the specific terrain. Then mark all the tiles that have some of that terrain. And then just paint which parts of the tile belong to which terrain. To map with the terrain, we have to go to the tilemap tab and to terrains. We can use the tileset paint tool to paint many other properties as well, such as modulate. Choose a color and click each tile you want to modulate. We can also paint a bunch of additional properties. To draw physics collisions, we need to define some physics layers in the property editor first. Then we can define a collider shape and paint it wherever we want. Navigation is done quite similarly. We can define arbitrary data for each tile, which is amazing. This makes stuff like move speed or sound based on the ground below you really easy to implement. We define a kind of custom data in the editor on the right. We can choose a name and data type. It seems like in the current version, painting these attributes does not work so well, but we have another option. We can select one or more tiles and adjust the properties that way. This gives us a bunch of additional options. We can now set the custom data for all these tiles. In this view, we can also define materials for specific tiles under rendering. This is quite amazing actually, because we can apply fancy shaders to tiles now. We can also define scenes as tiles. Just press the plus in the tileset and select a scenes collection. We can just drag and drop scenes in there and map with them. They even get a nice preview. Do you like the new tilemap? Let us know in the comments.